Hi there, my name is Scott Phillips. I'm the president and founder of StarFish Medical. Quality assurance and regulatory affairs in many ways are at the heart of medical device development. And for many people, they're the big mysteries, the sort of special expertise. So today we'd like to share with you some of that expertise. Vesna Janic, the head of our quality and regulatory department, will be presenting, as well as a number of our top experts. It's been a lot of fun putting this together for you. I hope you really enjoy it. Thank you.
My name is Vesna Janic, and I am a director of quality and regulatory department at StarFish Medical. I have a Bachelor of Science degree in biology, and I am a lead ISO 13485 auditor and a GLP inspector for Standard Council of Canada. I have over 20 years experience in quality and regulatory field, and I've been with StarFish for over 10 years. I have personally built a team of very capable quality and regulatory professionals, and we are very happy to be able to assist our clients in their regulatory and quality needs. Some of the examples are that we went to the client site during FDA inspection, and one of my colleagues was able to save the client from a major observation from the FDA by working with administrative assistant at the supplier site and making her demonstrate traceability for the part. Now, whoever knows how hard it is to demonstrate the traceability will understand how hard it was to lead somebody who is completely untrained, but he managed to do that and save the client from the finding.
Hello, I'm Helen Simons. I'm one of the senior QARA specialists here at StarFish Medical. I have over 15 years in product development, specializing in medical devices and IVD. I started in engineering and moved through project management and into quality, which gives me a good perspective on the challenges that project teams meet. Most recently here at StarFish, I've been working on the CEV ventilator project for the COVID-19 pandemic. This was an interesting project, being submitted under the Health Canada interim order, which was different to the usual submission process. We worked closely with Health Canada to understand their requirements to ensure that they would have the information they needed when we submitted the project. We pulled together the submission in 3 days from the point of the last verification test results coming in. We worked closely as a team between QA and RA to pull together all of the documents needed for the submission, each having our own tasks and being clear about how they interrelated so that we could quickly hand over as needed.
My name is Alexandra Reid, and I'm a QARA specialist at StarFish Medical. I have a PhD in plant molecular biology, and prior to joining StarFish, I was a reviewer for federal grant applications in science and engineering. During the pandemic, StarFish had to find new ways of working remotely. Not all of us had access to printers or scanners, and that meant collecting original signatures on documents problematic. And as auditors, we love original wet signatures on documents. So we had to find a new way of working. We chose to go with Adobe Sign because it met our regulatory requirements. However, we ran into a few hurdles as part of the process is it encrypts the documents, which is great for an audit trail. However, by trying to put them into a regulatory submission for Health Canada, we had to make a workaround by including the whole document within the PDF of the regulatory submission. We added bookmarks and links to these documents, which made finding them for the reviewers much easier. Definitely now the convenience of using e-signatures has meant we can go paperless, which means we can help save the trees.
My name is Deborah Pinchev, and I'm the Quality Assurance Regulatory Affairs Manager for the StarFish Medical Toronto location. An example of a key contribution towards a project comes from a time when a client was racing towards meeting a critical regulatory goal. They wanted to get their product approved in Europe under the MDD, and time was running out because notified bodies were beginning to only accept MDR applications. Basically, the entire team had to achieve months of work in a matter of weeks. As the StarFish QA, I had to make myself available to review dozens of documents at the drop of a dime and ensure we were still meeting our internal process while speeding towards this regulatory deadline. For me, this resulted in fielding last-minute requests on a daily basis, many long days, and digging deep and pushing through to be there for the team. In the end, it was worth it as the client met their CE mark goal. It was quite an experience for the entire StarFish project team.
My name is Tara Lysechko. I'm a senior quality assurance regulatory affairs specialist at StarFish. I've been with the company for a year and a half, and I actually started my career as a research scientist. I have a PhD in immunology, and I started out working for biotech companies developing novel medicines. We have a client who engaged StarFish Medical to intake the design of their device and to transition it to manufacturing. So we've been manufacturing their device for over 2 years now, and now they are ready to take it to the next step. One thing that you learn from this process is that when you have been the primary manufacturer the entire time, everything kind of has, you've worked out the kinks and it's moved smoothly. And as soon as you transfer it over to a second manufacturer, they may read through and have some issues that they need to be worked out that you take for granted are very easy to follow, but you may need to do some kind of tweaking, that kind of thing. Typically, we would go and do a site visit with the second manufacturer, and we would bring a device and we would help them work through assembly. In this case, due to the times right now, we actually made videos of each of the different assembly procedures so that they could run through them and have a visual as well as written instructions to help.
Hello, my name is Virginia Anastassova, and I'm a regulatory affairs manager and a senior QA at StarFish. I think regulatory affairs is a lot of fun. It's like a big puzzle and you have to fit all the pieces together, and you have pieces for many different disciplines. I'm going to give one example from my experience with StarFish. We had this product that we were working on, very interesting product. But then I asked the client if they've looked at their marketing potential, and they haven't. So they went back and they did some marketing studies, and they realized that doctors are not willing to pay 20 times more for something that costs a couple dollars and is the current clinical practice. We didn't get to do the design work, but on the other hand, we saved the client a lot of money and time.
Hi, my name is Azra, and my background is in biomedical engineering. I joined StarFish Medical on the bioservices team. I migrated to quality assurance and regulatory affairs about 2 years back, and I've been involved in many different projects. Recently, I was involved in an unannounced audit from Intertech, one of our notified bodies. I arrived to work thinking it was going to be a regular Thursday, and I was greeted by two members of Intertech wanting to perform an audit, as we are the contract manufacturers of one of our clients' device. It ended up being 8 hours of documentation review with very minimal findings on our client's part. It was an interesting experience and one that I can check off my bucket list as a member of QARA. After the visit, we had several internal meetings to fix those findings. We then sent the files to our client, and that was sent to Intertech and approved. My advice to clients would be to keep your paperwork up to date. It may cost a little more, but it will save you in the long run if you are ever caught in an unannounced audit.
If you'd like to know more about StarFish, we've been doing this for 20 years. We've developed hundreds of devices for companies all over the industry, and we've helped many founders become very successful and have big clinical impacts. That's what we really love for. So enjoy the content. If you'd like to talk to us about your project, we'd be happy to talk. Thank you.